Hey everyone, and welcome back to Royalty Now Studios, where we bring famous figures from the past to life with recreations and we talk about their history. Today's subject is the mysterious Lady of Elche statue, which has puzzled archaeologists for over a century. It has been called everything from an ancient Iberian masterpiece to a lost artifact of Atlantis. So let's first dive in with some history, and then of course I will reveal my statue recreations. Let's go. This limestone statue, known as the Lady of Elche, has always fascinated me. With her interesting headdress and her delicately carved, contemplative face. It turns out that the statue has quite a fascinating story to tell as well. It's actually much more mysterious than you would initially guess upon first glance. So she was discovered in 1897 at a private estate south of Elche, Spain, by a 14-year-old boy named Manuel. Upon her discovery, most archaeologists agreed that it was probably a statue made by the ancient Iberians around the 4th century BC. The elaborate carving was likely meant to represent the goddess Tanit, who was worshipped by the Punic Iberians thousands of years ago. The statue features an elaborate headdress with coils on each side, known as rodettes. And the statue is actually hollow with a hole in the back. It was originally brightly painted with beautiful colors. After its discovery, the historical community took note quickly of its unique appearance and its very visible worth. Later that month, it was sold to be displayed at the Louvre in Paris. Don't worry, it was later repatriated to Spain. However, it wasn't long before its mysterious nature and the inability of some scholars at the time to quite place it in Spain's history that it stirred up speculation that the statue was a forgery. The bust was first accused of being a forgery in 1906 by archaeologist José Ramón Melida. Melida speculated that the statue was too delicate to be an Iberian creation, which obviously insulted their artistic traditions. He said it may have even been a Hellenistic work that somehow made its way to Spain. However, this theory has been banished in recent years because of more and more discoveries. Essentially, the Lady of Elche was simply the first of this certain pattern to be discovered. The work looks less unique and mysterious when it's in the context of others that were found later. She was the first Iberian work to be discovered with this elaborate headdress and brightly colored pigments, so they thought it was just very unique and strange. But a few discoveries in 1971 and 1987 really shed light on this pattern of Iberian statue work. The Lady of Baza was discovered in 1971 and the Lady of Guardamar in 1987. Both of these statues have huge similarities to the Lady of Elche. They're both made out of limestone, and they were both previously brightly colored and richly adorned. In 2011, an analysis took place on the statue which confirmed its age. It was carved about 2,500 years ago, which tracks with what archaeologists initially thought. It also underwent a micropigment analysis which confirmed that no modern pigments or materials were found. It was authentically ancient. And the hole in the back of the statue was also analyzed, and they found trace particles of human remains, indicating that the statue's purpose was likely as a funerary urn. Now, it's unknown whether or not the carving of the woman is actually meant to represent the deceased human that was buried inside, but I think it's fun to recreate these statues anyway. Now, of course, even with all of this hard evidence, there are still theories that the woman may in fact be a lost priestess of Atlantis. Many say that her rodette-style headdress is not just religious garb, but actually an ancient technological device. The concentric circles could be meant to represent radio waves, or even the concentric circles of the famous lost city of Atlantis. The statue also has this interesting pointed head, which you can't see from the front, but it's very visible from this side view. And this side view also gives more insight into the rodette headdress. Now, I'll be honest, I don't buy into these theories, but there is many a rabbit hole to go down online if you're interested in learning more about the Atlantis theory. So let's go ahead and get to the recreations. Let's first check out the Lady of Elche in her ancient form, and then we will check out my modern day recreation of her. Thank you. you so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe if you want to support us bringing history back to life. And of course, check out the Royalty Now Etsy shop where we have bookmarks and prints of these recreations available. We will see you all for the next video.